Okay, so we're looking at the Rockola 474, which I believe is 1970s. And I'm going to show you, this is where the records actually displays what's playing. This is quite deceiving because it makes people think the record is playing. It's not. This is record now playing, and in this box here you will see the number come up when we actually start playing records. Obviously there's your coin slot and your reject, and here's the buttons which you can select your record with. Okay, now unfortunately the hydraulic gas struts here have stopped working, so I have to actually put this pole here to hold the lid up, which is a bit annoying. But anyway, let me show you inside. First of all, here we go. This is the lighting sequencer, which is in charge of these little things here, and you can change the speed as well. There it says increase speed. Here you have the mechanism, where this is basically the control unit for the whole device. As you can see, you've got two relays there, stop and a write-in relay. So this one here will click over when the arm has to stop at the selector, and this one here is the one that clicks when you actually type in your numbers. Obviously here you've got your play relay as well, which activates the arm and this device here. This is your credit unit, where the credits get put on, and down there you've got your actual coin mechanism. We'll go into more details of that in a bit. This is your amplifier. As you can see, it's integrated circuit stereo amplifier, which is quite interesting. And there you go, you can actually see this one's actually got valves, so it's very old. When it's actually been playing for a while, this valve gets very hot. And sometimes you will actually get a speaker overload if you're playing it too loud for too long. So yeah, you've got plenty of things here, and obviously you see that mute relay there as well. That's in charge of actually turning off the speakers if it does overload itself. And then of course you've got your circuit breakers up here as well, so they will actually stop the any circuits from overheating or blowing, which is great. So anyway, we'll have a look round. We'll have a look at the mechanism itself. We'll see how it operates. We'll also see exactly what the problem is with this one, and maybe one of you who's watching the video will be able to assist on fixing it. So, I hope you enjoy. Now, on this side, this is the selector arm, as it were. This goes round and flicks these switches either up. Obviously, it activates there because I've actually just flicked it, but it will select the flicked switch. So if I flick that one, for example, it will pick it up when it finds it. There you go. And it will cause the record to come on. Don't know which one this is going to be, if you can even hear it. Anyway, obviously, to stop the record, you can either lift up this arm and move it across, because there is actually a switch there. So as it goes across, it hits the switch, and the record goes back to place, and this will now go back to zero. Here, you've got your scan and operate. See if I can get this. Camera doesn't seem very good, does it? No. Anyway, here we go. This is your scan. You've got your off icon there, and then further back you've got your operate, but you can actually operate it in off because there's a little switch here. When the lid's closed, it will actually activate the jukebox as normal, but we'll keep it on there because that way we can actually operate it. I can manually scan through the records as well. This is used if you want to add a few records in. Anyway, so the other side here is, believe it or not, your pickup. So what it'll do is, when this side's been selected, the other side will come round and pick it up, but that will only work when I use my selecting device, which is this here. So now this is your integrated circuit, as it says there, solid state stereophonic music system. Stereophonic, I'm not really sure that's actually a word. I've heard of monophonic and things, but stereophonic, I thought that was a group, but anyway. So let's try something. Let's go one, two. Obviously your lights come up, you've got your first digit, your second digit, and your third one, so one, two, three. There you go, it's selected it. Your arm's going round, picking up your record. And your record will play. I'll tell you what, I'll just turn it up because I think that might help, and then you'll know it's actually playing. So behind the unit itself, You won't actually be able to see this, but there's a volume control. There we go. Now, you can see my problem that I've got at the moment is it actually plays the A and the B side, which we don't want. Now that there actually shows the amount of records that have ever been played on this machine. It's currently at 174,000. Quite a few. Anyway, so here we go. This is your area where you can select the bass and treble. And of course that's your mute relay. If you take that relay out, you'll actually get no sound at all now. So if I play a song. Okay, you do get a sound. I wonder what that's for then. Interesting. Somebody might be able to answer that for me. I didn't think I'd get any sound then. And then it's going to go for your B side again, which is rather annoying at the moment. Now, for those of you that don't know how this operates, up here, you've actually got a switch here, a little solenoid, which goes across, and that pushes down the lever. And when it pushes the lever down, it then clicks the switch, and as you can see, this switch here is now down. Now, what seems to be happening is both sides, there's one underneath as well, they both seem to be clicking up, which is causing the A and the B side to be going off. If any of you know what that could be, then do let me know, because basically there's two on each side and they're both triggering. Now they're working off contacts. If you look down there, can you see it's working off a contact which actually touches onto these lines here. And that contacts as it spins around, obviously, so that you don't have to use any wires, a bit like brushes really. So I don't know what that problem is. If you know what it is, that would really help me. If I pull this forward, this is your popularity wheel as well, which has the numbers on it, and obviously as the hammer clicks in here, I think you can manually do that just to show you. It should push these four, there you go. And that'll show you how many times in a night that particular record's been played, and at the end of the day, you reset it. So that's your popularity wheel. And yeah, obviously your speakers and your lighting system. A little bit complicated behind there. And well, I'll show you the coin mechanism, but I'm going to actually take it out to show you how it works. Okay, so here's your coin mechanism. National Rejectors. I wonder if that company still exists. Anyway, I can take this apart and show you exactly how it works. Now these two magnets here, actually, these days can get the coppers stuck in there, so you don't want to put coppers in this machine. Now, you'll see, it runs off weights. See that? two weights there, which actually, basically, if the coin's the right weight and the right size, that will fall down and allow it to drop through. And here you've got your clickers, which are switches basically, and if the coin, the coin hits it, so you can see there's actually a groove in there for the coin to hit. When the coin hits it, it basically triggers it, which tells this how many players you got. So if you listen to this, you'll hear a click. That's the noise you get when the coin drops through. So it's basically adding credits to the system. And I'll show you this credit thing, because this is amazing. There are so many little notches on the cogs there. I'll have to show you how it works. Anyway, let's stand this up. If I can stand it up, what I'll do is I'll rest it on my keyboard there. And you should be able to see when I drop this in here, this lever here should register the coin through. So you ready? Do you know what? I need to add a little bit more force to it, because obviously it needs to drop in like it does on the actual machine. So see if I can get this. There you go. It's quite quick, but this here dropped and it's now come out down here. And it will actually drop into the cash box at the bottom of the machine. Let's see if we can get that again, see if you can see this move. Ready? Let's see if it'll go. There you go. Straight down there. So that's your basic cash register. And to reject, what actually happens when you reject, believe it or not, is this pushes down and it pulls the whole thing out. So can you see it? And that causes the coins to drop down and out of the machine. Right, we're going to have a look at the coin rejector now. I've taken the screw out the top here. I don't think this is original, you know, I think this has been made. I don't think the normal Rockola one actually looks like this. But, again, you've got your relay there, you've got a switch, and you've got, if you can see them, can we get a nice view of that? There we go, got a big row of cogs there. And how this works, see if I can rest this in place. I need to put this somewhere for you to see it properly. Let's have a look. Alright, here we go. Now, what happens is, when it's triggered, this switch, the noise you hear there, that chick-chick sound, sorry, that was a great impression, that sound you get there is actually the cog moving round to say the play has been made, and I'll show you. So if we wind this back, okay, they're fully wound now. When you actually put a coin in, what happens is, if you watch the cogs there, they should move. Okay, now what should happen is when you've actually played it, this pushes down and pushes it back. Can you see? Can you see it push that back? It's pushing it back one by one. So when we press the play record, it's gone there, until it gets right back to the beginning. And when it's right back at the beginning, that light goes off there. So when you put a coin in, that light comes on. Select a single. When you've played it, see if I can wind it back. There you go, it's back out again. So that's all that does. This relay here, I believe that's in control of the buttons as well. Obviously it cuts off everything, so you can't use it. I'm not amazing on relays, so anybody who knows the answers to what these do, let us know. But there, that is amazing how this works, it really is. And as I say, it just pushes it back, and it's a simple method there. I will show you, I'll connect it all up and show you how it works. Okay, so the jukebox is closed. At the moment, the coin rejecting system is active. So you can see there's no lights on here at all. Try and put something in. Nothing happening, yeah? 50p. There you go. Select any single. Sorry, it's not very good. I'll tell you, this camera's not very good for an iPhone, is it? Anyway, I'm going to select our records. So, which we have 111. The light goes out because obviously I've just used my credit. And there we are. What I'll do is I'll actually get another coin out of the box because I don't actually have many coins on me at the moment. What I was going to try and do is show you a different coin, if I've got one, and try and get it stuck. About 20p, an actual modern 20p, is that right? No, that just comes straight back out of the rejection there. There's an old 50p here, I think it probably still accepts that as well. Okay, that's got stuck, that's good. So what we'll do is we'll press this. There you go. And the coins come back out. So it's got a bit dark here. See if this lamp works. There you go, that's better. Now you can see, that'll see why there's a golf ball in there, really not too sure. Keeping it safe, obviously. There you go. Right, now when this was in a pub, you'll probably find, let's just clear all these down here. Right, so there's nothing in it at the moment. What would have happened is, if somebody got their money stuck, for example, there's no lights on there, you say, oh, do you know what, just put 50p in there, I've got no credits. The barman, whoever owns it, would open it up and say, okay, fine, I'll give you another credit. And what happens is you press this button here, this red button here, which clicks the relay open, and you can manually add credits on. You can do that as many times as you like, so I'll take that right to the end now, and, you know, carry on using it. As I normally would, because obviously it's in the home, so we don't usually want to put money in it every 5 seconds. So anyway, there you go. There is the jukebox. Any questions? There's no, and I'll try and explain. But if anyone does know the answer to my question as to why this selection wheel here is selecting two pins at once, then please let me know.